inside the Team Canada room. Perfect so far at 4-0. And today, no room for imperfection. It's win or go home day. Canada will be in heritage red. Two Canadian boys, Shawn Mendes and Justin Bieber, get you set for a monster of a game.
I had a chip on my shoulder, had to let it go. 'Cause unforgiveness keeps them in control. I came in with good intentions, then I let it go.
In Alberta, these teams have been in the bubble for 3 weeks now, waiting for this, the playoff round. Team Canada has been together for 7 weeks now, longer than any other Team Canada. Three wins away from gold, a spot in the semis on the line tonight. Hello, Canada. James Duffy and Bob McKenzie with you. Craig Button will join us in just a second. Welcome to quarterfinal number three here at the World Junior Hockey Championship. Russia is already in. Finland is already in. Canada will try to join them with a victory tonight. And this is why it's important to win your group. Canada goes 4-0, perfect in group play. And the reason you want to do that is to avoid facing teams like Russia or the U.S. in a quarterfinal game. So they have earned the easier matchup on paper. Now their job is to make it look easy on the ice. To get you ready, Gord Miller and Ray Ferraro.
And so with Alex Newhook out of the Canadian lineup, once again, the Lions get juggled a little bit. Peyton Krebs has moved up and down. He's played in the power plays, killed penalties, really done it all.
He's been everything that was advertised before this tournament started for Canada. And you're right, Gord. He's been like a ping pong ball bouncing around the lineup. Wherever they've needed to move him due to some of the injuries or maybe the way that the Lions didn't jump out of the gate to Andre Tourigny's liking, they've moved Krebs to a spot, and he's given them the same thing all the time. Tenacity, energy, speed, gets to the front of the net. I've liked his game, and I think like Canada's game, his game has started to climb step by step through the preliminary round. 3 goals and 3 assists for the Las Vegas Golden Knights first rounder, and he's going to be a big part of Canada going forward.
Canada's won the last 4 meetings against the Czech Republic here at the World Junior Championship. James?
All right, thank you, boys. And Craig, they have not given up a 5-on-5 goal so far in this tournament. One of the main reasons is their goaltender, Devin Levi. What are your expectations for him and this, the biggest start of his career?
Well, what I would say is it's going to be exactly what you've seen up to this point. Steady, even, consistent, reliable. That's what Devin Levi provides for you. And when he grabbed the net in game one, he has grabbed it solidly, firmly, and showed no whisper of a break in his game or in his consistency, and that's why he continues to be the number one goaltender for Canada. I don't expect it to change at all.
Czechs got blown out twice but then upset the Russians, so how do they stack up against Canada?
On paper, they don't stack up. They're not as good in goal. They're not as good with team defense. They're not as good as team offense, but the game's played on the ice, as the Russians found out. The neutral zone is a landmine with the Czechs. The front of their net can be like a wall. The Swedes in the U.S. figured how to penetrate that, break it down, and blow the game wide open. The Russians did not, and as a result, they lost that game. So that's what the Czechs will be trying to duplicate, and Canada will be trying to take a page out of the Swedish American book.
Right, key for the Czechs to hang around early, and they've been good at that. They've been tied after the first period in all 4 games. Canada has scored within 4 minutes and change in all 4 of their games. So the start critical for both sides.
The 2021 World Junior Hockey Championship from Edmonton, Alberta is brought to you in part by Esso. The Esso brand has fueled Canada's love of hockey for over 80 years. By Nike, official gear of Canada's national hockey teams. By TELUS, helping build stronger communities on and off the ice. When we give back together, we're all connected for good. And by Tim Hortons, the official coffee of Team Canada. You listen. The 2021 World Junior Hockey Championship from Edmonton, Alberta is brought to you in part by Chevrolet. Find new reasons to cheer. Find new roads.
The first two quarterfinal games of the day came right down to the wire. Now it's time for quarterfinal number three as Canada takes on the Czech Republic. Referees are Fraser Lawrence from Edmonton, Tyson Stewart from Elmont, Ontario, Maxime Chaput from Saint-Jérôme, Quebec, and Kelsey Maloney from Narral, Manitoba are the linesmen. Starting in goal for the Czechs is Nick Malik. He allowed 7 goals on 41 shots in the Czechs' opening loss to the Swedes, had a shutout against Austria. He's an 18-year-old whose dad, Eric Malik, was a long-time NHL player. There is Devin Levi, who started every game for Canada, leads the tournament with a .951 save percentage. Behind the bench for the Czechs for the first time in this tournament is Karel Zeleniak. Began coaching at the age of 27 in the Czech Republic. Has coached at the under-18 level as well for their country. And there is Andre Tournier, a 4-time assistant coach for Canada, was a member of their team last year and won a gold medal in Ostrava in the Czech Republic. Connor McMichael.
We'll take the face off. Let's be some good boys tonight.
Here we go. Well, they'll try, I guess. Bowen Byram snaps that pass rink wide. Again, Alex Newhook not in the Canadian lineup tonight. So drawing his defenseman Jordan Spence. As Cousins moves in and shoots. Malik makes the stop. The puck is loose.
Hey, we're good. Good job, boys.
And Cousins an early chance here. 15 seconds in.
Well, Cousins jumps onto the loose puck. It tests Malik, who's sliding out of the net a little bit. This play's flipped up into the air, and Michael Coutil wants to bat it away. However, he bats it right onto the stick of Cousins, who delivers this, and Malik is sliding to his right. Something to keep an eye on as this game moves along.
Byram plays it back to Drysdale. Jamie Drysdale, a long shot, goes off the end board. Got a chance in front, a rebound. Cousins had that kicked away.
Cousins to grade A chances here in the first 25 seconds.
It was Lucas Parikh who was in goal for the Czechs in their 2-0 win against the Russians. Are you surprised at all that it's Malik, not Parikh, who gets the start here today?
I am, actually, because of the way that he played against the difficult competition of Russia. However, when he played the next night, or the next game against the United States, who play a more similar game to Canada, it was 7-0.
He got pulled in the third period of that one. Chipped ahead by Pelche. After it is Quinton Byfield. Malik out to play it. Nick Malik, born in Raleigh, North Carolina, when his dad was playing there for the Hurricanes. Thomas Harley. Mississauga Steelheads of the Ontario League, back at his own blue line to pick it up. Feeds across for Braden Schneider. Schneider, lead pass for Byfield. He's got Pelche moving in. Byfield shoots. Malik knocks that away. Chopped that by Quinn, goes back to center ice. And Mujic plays that back down to the Canadian zone. Levi brings it around for Pelche, up to Byfield. Byfield slowly rolls that down to the check zone. And gets off on a change as icing was waved on. Michael Krutil, a Chicago fourth round pick, slides it back across, knocked in by Radek Kucherov. Czechs were eighth last year, lost their quarterfinal matchup 5-0 to Sweden. In comes Krebs, a centering pass bounced in behind the intended target, King Doolin. Czechs are without a medal in this tournament in the last 15 years. Their last medal was a bronze in Grand Forks in 2005. Back at the point, long shot by Justin Barron, bounces over to Cooley with a drive, that's blocked as well. That's what we talked about in the pregame, Ray, the blocked shots by the Czech Republic in that game against the Russians. Barron has a look, being shadowed there. And Rielofsky shoots, and Rielofsky got in the way of that.
Oh, man, Rielofsky is hurting here. He's got a bad hand from an initial block. He stayed into the shift and gets another one here. His right hand is is hurting him yet. He's telling the official, I can't go here. If they're trying to explain it to him.
Right.
This is the earlier save. Cousins from about 2.5 feet hits the top of the pad of Nick Malik, who in a desperation move makes the stop.
So Rylovski does get permission to go to the Czech bench. Or did not, pardon me, he comes on late. So after the icing, he's got to stay on.
I don't know if that was a little bit of language barrier or what, but he's hurting a lot here, but he stays on the ice. Looks like he's going to be okay.
It was Rylovski who made the play on the first Czech goal against the Russians.
Great pitch by Drysdale to keep this alive.
Drysdale up for Mercer. Dawson Mercer back to Drysdale. Shoots it off a leg in front. Might say that a lot this afternoon. Jumping up is Drysdale. Holds the line. And Drysdale throws it back in behind the goal for Tomasino. Well, Tomasino looking there for Suzuki. Now Byram ranges up. Owen Byram slides that down to Suzuki in for Tomasino. Tomasino belted there by Schmozil. Puck loose at the side of the goal. Tomasino hooks it back in front. And Malik will pounce on that. And we welcome into our virtual fan club fans from the Czech Republic who love their hockey. We saw it last year in Ostrava, a fantastic World Junior Championship there. They love their music too. The organist had a candelabra in the arena.
Classy. Canada really putting the pressure on early here against a very young Czech defense. Four of their top six defensemen are 18 or younger, including one that's not eligible, number 8, Juracek, till the 2022 draft.
Now it's side of the goal. There's a pick chance for Holloway, and Holloway had that picked away. 10 of these Czech players are young enough to return next year. Moved up by Jan Mišák. Mišák, a Montreal second rounder. Had that taken away as it's punched out by Cousins. Wave back for Long. In comes Hosh. His pass chipped away by Cousins. Now back at the point is Hosh. The time moves it and shoots. Levi to save. Rebounds back in the high slot for Cousins. And Dylan Cousins lays it back down the Czech zone. Officially, Canada has only one shot in the game. Cousins had one right away. Then the second one was kicked out.
He said there'd be no math, Gord.
Belche with it. This is not the shot clock counter at Madison Square Garden, I can tell you that. There'd be 14 on there by now. Belche winds in. Novak as it chopped down by Gulli. Back down the Czech zone. Kubicek goes back to pick it up.
Oh, what a nice play. That's the young defenseman, the 17-year-old Juracek.
Now drop back. Kubicek a chance, and Levi makes the stop, and there's no rebound.
So just think of the pace and the pressure you're under as a young defenseman. 6'3", 176 pounds, David Juracek. Not draft eligible till 2022. What a nice little feathery dish to the winger, and the Czechs out of the zone get a good scoring chance on this as Kubicek gets to walk directly into the slot. He had a goal and a couple assists last year in the tournament. A really good chance there, turned aside by Devin Levi.
Faceoff was won by Brickrill, but the shot was deflected away. Now Zeri moving in. He watched there by Kucherik. And behind the goal is Krebs. Krebs walks out, spins and shoots, and Malik able to make the stop. And we welcome those of you watching from across Canada on this Saturday afternoon slash evening. Our pal on the bottom right is my favorite. Flaps down, beard on.
The only guy I've seen with a hat like that seriously is the UFO Wizard. He sported a really, really cool one.
Back at the 2013 tournament.
Yep.
And the Wizard costume, which hence the nickname. Back in by Perfetti. Krebs digging for it. Krebs drops it back. Perfetti, a quick shot that deflected high and wide. On it now is Zeri. Perfetti banks it back to Byram, but the pass was intercepted. Adam Nyman moved it out for the Czechs. Back in by Philip Kofer. A number of these Czech players have played Major Junior in North America as Perfetti brings it out. In comes Cole Perfetti. Of course, the Quebec League is the only major junior league in Canada that's played games so far this year. Harley digs for it. Tomasino works it free. Still loose in the corner. Tomasino gets it again. Around the boards it goes. Knocked down by Schneider. Braden Schneider. Whistles that back in. It gets by Tomasino. Harley steps up on the other side. Top line's on the ice for the Czechs. Mercer can't hold the line. The play is called offside. Well, we welcome the families of these two players. Jack Quinn's family and the Pelletier family. The Pelletiers are in Quebec City. And the Quinns are in Cobden, Ontario. Hello there. Happy New Year. Nervous.
Oh, yeah.
Big collision there. Schneider out of Raschka. And Raschka has been a physical player in this tournament.
He plays up on the edge quite frequently. Was suspended before the tournament started on a late hit in a 6-0 game. But he is going to run around as he gets a piece of goalie there.
Canada ices the puck, and so the faceoff back down to the Canadian zone.
Schneider still shaking off that hit in the neutral zone as he attacks up into Raschka. Raschka goes down and a rather awkward fall as Schneider goes all the way down to the ice and falls awkwardly on that right side.
Face off one by Suzuki back at the point. That long shot deflected wide from Kucherov. Now Mužik has his shot blocked. Harley was almost off to the races there. And now Gulli swings back to pick up the puck. Gulli moves it high off the glass, back down, and Krutil trying to milk an ice and gets it. And the faceoff right back down at the end. Canada can't change.
Braden Schneider was suspended for a game as well earlier in the tournament for a big open ice hit. Trouble getting in, trouble getting a little help at the bench, and looks like he's okay. He's still wringing that shoulder around as Adam Raschka, and he had crashed to the ice pretty heavily.
Off the faceoff, that's whistled wide by Tepley. Up on the boards, here's Mercer with it. Dawson Mercer. Both back to the point, scores a long shot. Levi the same, it's out of the reach of Tepley. Good pressure now from the Czechs as Canada's still got tired players on the ice. And Tomasino races to it. Lifts it high in the air, and this time Canada will be able to change. Stanislav Svozil back for it. Played in the Czech Extra League last year as a 16-year-old.
And he's eligible for this year's draft.
And Svozil lines it, plays it back around for Tepley. Tepley still behind the goal by McMichael, and Barron's got it back. Up ahead to Cousins, moving in with Holloway. Byram jumps into the rush as well. The puck knocked away by Svozil. There's Tepley back with it. Tepley with Nishak. It's off his skate, and the play's offside at the Canadian line. No score here in the first period. It's the quarterfinals of the World Junior Hockey Championship.
3 goals on 61 shots for Devin Levi in this tournament. The thing that's impressed me most is his ability to control his rebounds. It's been a little bit of a jittery start for Levi as the puck has hit him and bounced away a couple of times. He's done an amazing job of not just controlling the puck and killing the play, but making the save and getting it into the corner into safety. A little bit of a reset for him, a little relax here. The first one and out game for him for Hockey Canada.
This is the toughest day. You lose this one, yeah, you're done. If you lose in the semis, you get to play in a bronze medal game. But this is the win or out.
And you really feel like the tournament's a flop if this is the one you miss. Now, Germany would be pleased with their efforts and certainly to push the Russians as they did earlier today. But you can't tell me the Swedes feel this was a good tournament for them. They end up losing 3 straight games, including blowing a 2-0 lead today against the Finns.
Fed down to the Canadian zone, and quickly on that is Nyman for the Czechs. Nyman leads it down to Copper. Back in the point when it goes to Kubicki, and it bounces off the back of the net. Brailovsky feeds that back. Kubicki's shot was blocked. McMichael lifts it high in the air for Cousins. In comes Dylan Cousins. Cousins in alone. Stopped by Malik. No, scores. It dribbles it off Malik, and Canada's taking a 1-0 lead. Cousins has done it again.
Well, Connor McMichael plays this out into open ice, and Cousins is off to the races. A block shot and a little chip flip, and you're not going to catch Cousins. Malik makes about 80% of the save, but the third scoring chance of this first 9 minutes for Dylan Cousins goes off Malik's glove, off his pad, and squeaks through the five hole, and Canada has a 1-0 lead 8.5 minutes in.
Cousins has retaken the goal scoring lead in the tournament with his seventh. Burst onto the scene internationally for Canada in this building in the summer of 2018 at the Hlinka Gretzky Cup. He was dynamite there. A scoring star for Lethbridge in the Western Hockey League. And a first round pick of the Buffalo Sabres that they can't wait to get. Drysdale lead pass for Zeri. Connor Zeri tries to pivot back. Kicking out is Krebs. Perfetti in there as well. And Krebs wins that battle for the puck.
That thing's still alive as Krebs is working one-on-two. Perfetti on the outside trying to wait for that puck to pop free. Here it is.
Perfetti threw that towards the goal. It was blocked by Raschke. Now Raschke moves in. The checks are changing. Raschke in on Drysdale. It bumps him off the puck. Byram back for it. Reverses for Drysdale. And now Byram having a collision in the slot. Lujic is late to get back into play. Pelche shoots, and that's blocked. Pelche taken in by Svozil. Here's Hawks with it. He gets crunched there by Byfield. And now as the checks touch up, a penalty coming. It's going to be an interference call against the checks as Adam Raschke, who knows the way to the penalty box, will go off.
The Czechs have not killed penalties checks at all in this tournament. They've given up 6 power play goals against in just 15 tries. Here will be the penalties. Raschke will come in. I mean, there's no need to hit Pelche. The puck's over here. Easy call. Here's the goal. Cousins deflects the puck. McMichael pitches it into open ice, and you're not going to catch Dylan Cousins in the open ice. And he gets a bounce, a break, and it's 1-0 Canada. The Canadian power play has had their struggles getting untracked here in this tournament. 5 for 15, but they got 2 against Germany and 3 against the Swiss. Got skunked in their last 2 against Slovakia and Finland.
Drop back for Byfield. Cousins leads the way for Canada with 2 power play goals. Byfield plays it around. Quinn. In for Suzuki. Back at the point now to Drysdale. Cross to Tomasino. In, shoots. Malik makes the save. Puck still loose. They battle away for it. And the puck is not sticking to Nick Malik today. And now at the line, the Czechs just clear it out. Tomasino moves in as Canada gets fresh legs on the ice. Krebs holds the line. In comes Krebs. Suzuki goes on, Perfetti comes on. Tomasino, back to Byram, across to Perfetti. Cole Perfetti, back to Byram. Byram has a look, Perfetti. Keeps on the goal line for Krebs. 45 seconds to go on the power play. Perfetti a chance, and Malik got a piece of that. Here's Byram as Cousins comes on. Byram buys some time, McMichael on now as well, Krebs. Back to the goal line, Perfetti to Krebs, in shoots, and Malik punches that away. Cousins, back for Byram, and the pass misfires.
And a bad break as the puck hopped over Byram's stick, but that's really good puck movement and really good movement by Canada in particular. I'm liking the bumper guy. In that case, it was Quinn. He's moving up and down in the slot, making himself available for a pass.
Byram. Up for Cousins, winding in. Dylan Cousins drops it off the Krebs, he's up towards the goal, but he kicks that away. Now Byram back with it. 4 shots in the power play, and just after it, forward, Byram fires it home. 2-0 Canada.
That will not be a power play goal, as Raschke had just stepped onto the ice. But after virtually 2 minutes of power play pressure, is going to get his first goal of the tournament, and this one squeaks through Nick Melik as well. Byram's got it. Hold, hold, hold. And eventually, Dylan Cousins' screen makes it difficult for Melik to see this as Cousins flashes in front. You see Cousins just get out of the way right through the 19 hole under his arm and into the net. Canada's got a 2-0 lead.
Gray, it's not like Malik's been beaten cleanly on the two goals.
No,
they both hit him, but
both of them. May has got about 80% of the puck. He just cannot squeeze them out both times. And Canada off to an excellent start.
Came 4 seconds after the power play ended. Puck loose in the corner.
Team Canada goals.
Trying to think of free is Holloway. Mercer. Holloway's prowess in digging out loose pucks has earned him the nickname the Golden Retriever for Canada. Also has blonde hair, which works nicely with the nickname.
Lots of energy, a tenacious forechecker. He's been banged up in this tournament as well.
Through two. Moves around Holloway, shoots, and Levi gets a piece of that. Bounces down to Peltier off the sideboards, but not out. Kucherov plays it back in. Shots are 7-4 in favor of Canada. Harley, pass ahead to Cousins, chips it down. Quinn goes after it. Malik plays that around, but Byfield sealed the wall. Cousins has it back. Cousins lays it back in deep to Quinn. Tries to fight off David Vitus. Stays on it, finally picked up by Jiříček. Out to center ice it goes. Barron picks it back up ahead to Byfield. In comes Quinton Byfield, leaping around Jiříček. Drops it off to Quinn. The puck bounced off his stick. Drouin steps up and keeps the puck alive at the line. Mužík couldn't poke it out. Now Byfield back on it. To Gouley. On come Perfetti and Krebs for Canada. But the puck goes over the glass and out of play. Bowen Byram has his first of this World Junior Championship to make it 2-0. To the delight of Stacy and Sean and Grandma Jane in Cranbrook. Dylan Cousins has a point in every game for Canada, and courtesy of Lethbridge PA announcer Dustin Forbes, here's his record in this building. 18 games, 16 goals, 32 points between Lethbridge, the Hlinka-Gretzky Cup here in 2018, and this tournament. He's got to get the Oilers moved into their division in Buffalo.
Yeah, you know, while they were moving the divisions around this year, Buffalo to Edmonton might not quite be squeezed together.
That was you at the Montreal Forum, right?
Loved that place. Loved it.
Mužík moves ahead now for the Czechs. Byram stepped into him, and Mužík has to turn back. Byram to Drysdale, up the ladder for Krebs. That pass ticked away.
And then Krebs deposited Baranek into the Czech bench.
Played around by Kucherov. And up he goes to Krutil. Up for Hoffer. A little backhand shot goes wide from Nyman. Walking from the point, that long shot by Kucherov is gloved by Levi.
Closed captioning of the 2021 World Junior Hockey Championship is proudly delivered to you by DoorDash. Get $0 delivery for your first month. Delicious delivered.
In our opening, we talked about the tenacity of Peyton Krebs, and here he gets a chance to lay the shoulder into the chest of Martin Baranek, and he sends him three quarters the way into the Czech bench. We saw earlier where Krebs was basically in a one-on-two battle for the puck. He kept it alive till Perfetti could come and retrieve possession.
Bouncing puck right in front, Cousins put that just wide.
Cousins is everywhere in this first period.
Cousins back on in the corner. Cousins gets bumped off the puck by Kubicek. Another collision in front of the Czech bench. Harlan up ahead to McMichael. That was knocked away by Tefley. The puck loose at center ice, scooped up by Cousins. Up for McMichael. Holloway coming in. The long shot by McMichael is gloved by Malik. Dylan Cousins, the workhorse from Whitehorse, has 2 points, including a goal, as Canada has a 2-0 lead. Tangerine Raptors basketball continues Friday as the Raptors tip off against the Sacramento Kings. Coverage starts at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific on TSN. The Matark Conservatory in the foreground here at Edmonton. On this Saturday evening, still to come tonight at 8:30 Eastern time, 6:30 local, the fourth quarter final of the day will have the United States against Slovakia. Earlier today, Russia with a narrow 2-1 win over Germany, and then Finland. A last-minute goal to win it 3-2 against the Swedes.
I don't know how many times they've done this, whether it's in this tournament or the World Championships. Down 2-0, look like they're out of the game. They get back in it, then they got a fight and claw. They get a disallowed goal. They don't go away. And then two goals in the last 5 minutes or so. A power play goal and then the winner with about 30 seconds left. And just a remarkable comeback for them.
Got pulled ahead by Vitush. Finds Novak, a backhand shot kicked up by Levi. Sharp save there by Devin Levi. Svozil comes dancing in. Svozil drops it back, goes back at the point. There's Novak, a shot that bounced away in front. Tomasino's got it back now. And Tomasino out with Mercer. Kucherov leads the Czechs in ice time at just over 20 minutes a game. Fires that down. It's been a really bizarre tournament for the Czechs. Is that stolen there by Kipio for a moment? They lost 7-1 to the Swedes in their opener. Then beat the Russians in that great game, 2-0. Kipio in, shoots, that deflects wide. Levi's lost his goal, but it bounces right back to him. Then the next day, they got clobbered 7-0 by the U.S., then beat the Austrians 7-0. Krutil shoots, that deflects over the glass, and out of play.
Levi lost his stick. Then he had it bounce back to him, and by the end of the play, he's got it back where it belongs. Strong move here by Pavel Novak. The Minnesota Wild draft choice is able to drive in and set up a chance. Turned aside by Levi, who looks like he's settled in quite nicely.
Turned 19 during this tournament, a computer science major at Northeastern University.
Likely the only goaltender in his class in the computer science.
Wow.
I played with a few goalies, you know.
Milovsky with a chance, and Levi knocks that away.
Of course, I wouldn't have been in the class anyway.
So how would you know what I have been? Another chance, and a good stop by Levi. A rebound. And a good shot there for Nyman. The Czechs have had some pressure in the last couple of minutes. Centered, and Nyman just missed on that. Juracek moves in now. Perfetti stepped into him, and then Schneider finishing the job. Loose at the side of the goal, Levi down, and Suzuki's got it back ahead to Krebs. Out comes Krebs, lays it down to the check zone as Canada changes. Krebs hard after, the nearest teammate's about 80 feet away at the moment. It's tied up and throws it back in front, picked out there by Mischak. You liked Mischak last year in the Czech Republic.
I thought he had a terrific tournament, and then when he went to Hamilton after the tournament, he really exploded on to the radar, really, to push his draft stock up.
Yeah, a chance there now, and Mischak turned away by Levi.
Little bit of work by Levi as he makes the blocker stop on Richlovsky. He made a leg save later on, and to me, after a couple of bobbles early, maybe a little nerves, perhaps. He looks like he's really settled in.
That's poked out by Cousins. So we know that Russia and Finland are off in the semifinals. We don't know the matchups yet. They reseed after this round. The teams are ranked from 1 to 8 going in. The highest remaining seed plays the lowest remaining seed. Canada is number 1 going in. Now moved ahead. In comes Mischak, shoots, and Levi makes the stop, and there's no rebound.
That's a great example of what Levi does. Mischak gets a scoring chance. He's a good shooter, and he's got an opportunity from a grade-A scoring chance.
Levi reads the play. He doesn't get out too far in case he's got to go across the net. He's able to make the save and smother it. There's no rebound. There's no extra play. He doesn't create any extra mess for himself, which in the earlier game today, and we've commented on it.
Another quick chance, and Novak turned away by Levi.
And there's another one. Just to finish the thought, we've commented on Yaroslav Askarov of the Russians. He makes a lot of his own mess. When the puck hits him, it bounces back in the slot. Look, Levi's got to find the puck off the faceoff. Novak gets a lot on this. It hits him high in the chest, but drops right down. He's able to smother it before there's any extra play.
Scouts use the term, the puck sticks to him, to describe goalies that don't give up rebounds. As Tomasino moves in. Disparagingly, scouts will say a goaltender was hard to hit if he wasn't very good. Really a long shot, and that's deflected wide by Tomasino. Still loose, Mercer digs that free. Back to Gulick. Now back in the slot, Tomasino tees it up, and Malik knocks that way in the end. It's the sunroof of the truck parked in the corner.
Guy's got a good parking spot. Tomasino came out of the blocks in this tournament with four goals in his first three games. Didn't get anything in the last one against the Finns, but man, that kid can shoot the puck. He doesn't need a lot of room. Uses a long stick, and he's able to move the puck 4 or 5 feet when he delivers it. 100 points in 62 games last year.
Quinn trying to dig it free. Puck still loose. Quinn trying to work that free, sign of the goal. Backhanded by Byfield. Now Quinn back with it. Final minute now of the period. Schneider back across to Quinn. His shot ramps off the stick of Juracek. Back in the corner. There's Byfield trying to work it free again. Now moved out by the Czechs. Here comes Mužík. His shoot-in bounced right onto the stick of Beranek. Beranek was offside. There's still Tomasino from Mississauga, Ontario. His mom, those are her socks.
So good. It's funny, some people can watch their kids play with total ease. I don't know who they are, but there are people like that. When my kids were playing, like, I just know that while they're on the ice, don't talk. When they're off the ice, feel free to have a conversation.
Interestingly enough, that applies to soccer now as well, because Riley and Reese, when they're playing, that's the same. I've been to their games. And it's
yeah,
the same.
I don't. While the ball's in their area, let's just watch the game, would we?
Our friend and colleague Bob McKenzie would be in the category of leave me alone during the game when Mike was playing. Bob had a lot of things to say, but you were not allowed to say things back.
You just accept? You just accept him, yeah.
Had the program rolled up, slapped it against the wall when he stood there, and had a lot to say, but you don't say anything back.
Oh. Interesting. The program.
Well, if you wanted to ride home from...
Yeah, exactly. It's a long walk.
From Canton, New York, if you want to ride home, you better not say anything. Drysdale, up ahead to Cousins. Shots are 12-8 in favor of the Czechs. Canada with a 2-0 lead. Drysdale moves around Mirlovsky. Throws that down to Holloway. Chris crossing with Cousins. Puck loose at the sign of the goal, and Nick Malik grabs that.
There's almost been two periods here, Gord, as I'm watching this, you know, watching this first period play itself out. When Canada has the puck, they look strong, they control it. When they don't have it, they've chased a little bit. They've left some open ice, and as a result, the Czechs have 12 shots on goal. I'm sure they'll want to tighten that up as they get into the second period.
At the point, Drysdale shot that deflects wide. Nick Malik's dad played a couple of World Juniors for the Czech Republic. He played with Sioux in the Ontario Hockey League. And his team is down a couple here after one period of play as Canada gets goals from Cousins and Byram in this third of four quarterfinals today. You're watching the 2021 World Junior Hockey Championship from Edmonton. Our first intermission with James Duffy and the crazy hockey dad, Bob McKenzie, is coming up.
Tangerine Raptors basketball continues Friday as the Raptors tip off against the Kings, finally getting their first win of the year against the Knicks on Thursday night. They're 1-3. They'll try to improve on that. 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific time here on TSN. James Duffy, Bob McKenzie, and momentarily Craig Button here on your first intermission with Canada up 2-0. It was Craig who coined and copyrighted the workhorse from Whitehorse to describe Dylan Cousins. The Quizmaster, who's doing a great job running things behind the scenes here, came up with the Yukon goal rush. Whatever you call him, Bob, he's been Canada's best player in this tournament. And we're seeing a theme with defensive plays leading to instant offense.
That's right. The straw that stirs the drink for Team Canada has most certainly been Dylan Cousins on that top line. Co-captains, now that Kirby Dach is down. He gets a stick on this ever so slightly in the defensive zone, and that allows the puck to go to Connor McMichael. Great alley-oop in anticipation by Connor McMichael, the second best offensive forward for Team Canada, and Cousins finishes off. Now, earlier, we saw the game against Finland. Cousins creates his own turnover in the defensive zone, neutral zone, comes down, buries it, scores a goal. Terrific defensive awareness that leads to offense, and he did it against the Slovaks as well, only this time he got the puck up to Phil Tomasino for a goal that iced the game for Canada. So Cousins, strong work in the defensive zone, help from the teammates getting the alley-oop on that one with Connor McMichael. He gets it done.
And Craig, different action but equally effective on the second goal.
Yeah, and Bob talked about Dylan Cousins being the straw that stirs the drink. He's the engine that drives this team. He revs at high RPMs, and as he gets this puck, he's moving with speed, but he's got the mentality that he's gonna attack through the middle that opens up a lot of the play and pushes the Czech defenders back. But then he stands in front of the net and becomes the front that screens Nick Malik, and it, Bowen Byron's able to slip it in, but no question that he has been Canada's best player.
Usually with the Czechs, when they fall behind, they tend to fold. We saw that in the game against Sweden and the U.S. where they got blown out, but a little bit flipping the script in this one, Craig, where as soon as they went down 2-0, they kind of took over that period. How?
Well, they ended up being able to take advantage of their opportunities, but Devin Levi has shown from the outset of this tournament that he is not going to allow opponents to gain a confidence that they can score goals. Despite the pressures and the efforts of Czech Republic, Devin Levi just shuts the door time and time again. 0-0, 1-0 you're up, 2-0 you're down. It doesn't matter. The stability of Devin Levi is exceptional, and he doesn't give the opponents any sense that they can beat him.
And the reason why Devin Levi had to be good down the stretch was because Canada's puck management became absolutely brutal in the back half of that period. After they had the 2-0 lead, they got complacent. They started turning pucks over in the neutral zone, in the defensive zone, and Levi was forced to make some really good saves. The Czechs are the best counter-attacking team in this tournament. If you make mistakes, they will eventually make you pay for it. Canada's got to really tighten things up, and I'm sure that'll be a message from Andre Tournier to his team, because they gave up 9 straight shots on goal in that first period.
First time in this tournament the Czechs have been behind after one period of play. Usually their problems have happened in the second and the third. We continue on the first intermission with Canada up by 2 from the bubble in Edmonton. Join Canada's national women's team for the Pond to Podium Development Series, connecting participants directly with Team Canada players and staff through a series of free webinars focusing on player development, skill sessions, and question and answer panels. Register today. Time now for the World Juniors High Performance, fueled by Gatorade.
Here's a shorthanded chance from 11, scores! Ponomariov gets the break. Raymond on the power play, plays it for Soderblom, scores! Back between the legs and up to the top corner.
Yeah, what a beauty.
Lundell on it again, plays for Hirvonen. Hirvonen center, Pettman, oh, what a chance! Scramble in front of the net, all the way down, scores!
Finland has taken the lead.
Look at the joy on the Finnish bench.
Now your tournament scoring leaders brought to you by Gatorade. Rehydrate, replenish, and refuel. And with Dylan Cousins' goal and an assist in the first period, now tied for the tournament lead with Trevor Zegras, and he leads in goals with seven. And those three German players are done for the tournament, so it looks like a two-man scoring race the rest of the way. Bowen Byram with his first goal of the tournament for Canada, the second of the game, and he's with Ryan Rashad.
Well, Bowen, I know that's a team that can kind of squeeze you guys pretty tight at times. How do you think your team responded to the style that they were trying to play in that period?
Yeah, I don't know. I think the intentions there, but we're just a little sloppy with our puck management, throwing some pucks away that I don't think we need to. So we'll address that in the intermission here and then go at it again in the second.
First goal for you in your second World Junior. When you're playing at this tournament, how much do you reduce the risk that might be in your game just in terms of the offense that you look for compared to when you're playing?
Yeah. I mean, everyone here is good players. Every team's good, so you got to be smart with how you play. Like I said, you got to manage pucks. So I'm just trying to play a solid two-way game, and I feel like I'm doing a pretty good job of that. It's always nice to chip in the offense, though.
Feeling lots of support from Cranbrook. We've got some video of the folks and Grandma Jane. Tell us something that Grandma Jane taught you in your life.
I don't know. She's a pretty cool old lady. It's a lot of fun hanging out with her. My family's always fun to be around. So
All right. Good stuff. Thanks, Bowen.
Awesome. Thanks, Ryan.
Thank you so much.
I've been loving these look-ins at the families from their various homes. The quality shot locations brought to you by SportLogic. Czechs with actually a one advantage, 8-2, but at Canada with the two red dots and the two goals so far. Second period just ahead. Biebs, Mendes, take us to break.
Canada strikes twice. Dylan Cousins with a goal and an assist has now moved past John Tavares in his sole possession of sixth place on Canada's all-time point list at the World Juniors. Two behind Jason Allison for fifth. Gord Miller back here with Ray Ferraro. Sick of talking about Dylan Cousins yet?
Nope. I love the way he plays. I think he draws the team into the game. From the very first shift today, it was very obvious that Cousins was determined to make this a Canadian day. Two chances in his first two shifts, denied by Nick Malik. And then he's on the forecheck. He's quick onto the puck. All over the ice, Cousins makes an impact. Defensively, he started this play. He gets the breakaway. It rattles around. He doesn't know what's in the net until he's in the corner. But Cousins continues his exceptional play for Canada. A 2-0 lead in a period where I don't think the Canadians were particularly sharp without the puck. They gave up 12 shots, which is something they have not done in this tournament before.
Cousins, the tournament goal-scoring leader, now tied with Trevor Zegras of the U.S. for the tournament point lead. Zegras plays tonight for the U.S. against Slovakia. Five on five here in the second period. There has been only one power play in the game. It went to Canada. And Canada scored 4 seconds after it ended. Fired down by Lang into the Canadian zone. That'll be icing against the Czech Republic.
For Canada, I think the message has to be to turn up the pressure on the Czech defense. The Czechs have had trouble with pace in this tournament. Shut out 7-0 by the United States and walloped way back in their first game 7-1 by Sweden. But when the pace gets high, it seems like they can't deal with it very much. I thought at times Canada was on it in the first period. At other times, they seemed to get a little sloppy with the puck.
Byram back with it. He lost the puck for a moment. Line was in on him, and now Drysdale has it back. Krebs chips that to Perfetti. And Cole Perfetti had that knocked away by Stanislav Svozil, who, as you mentioned, is eligible for the upcoming NHL draft. Drysdale, a hard shot that's knocked away by Malik. Krebs comes in. Shoved his man off the puck. As he moved long there. Spent 10 minutes on the phone with the Czech team manager trying to get the pronunciation right. That long shot goes off the side of the net from Michael Gut. It's not Lang. It's not really long. It's kind of like Lund.
Remember Robert? I played with Robert Lang. It was Robert Lang. I'm so confused. Oh, yeah, dead center in the top.
That's Czech hockey right there.
I love it.
What a fantastic place to watch a hockey game.
That World Championship was one of the great places to watch a game. It was Jaromír Jágr's last hurrah with the Czech national team. And when they would chant, you could feel the building move with the intensity of it.
And then they do it on the train back to the hotel afterwards, too. If you are not hopping, you are not Czech. Mužík up for Prickrill. That pass was broken up. As Kolce got in the way, and now Byfield races to it. Byfield pokes out ahead, and it bounces back to Barron. Gouley. Pass for Kolce, who deflects that with a skate in the offensive zone. Now Quinn with a shot that's deflected wide by Nyman. Quinn with Canada changing. Plays it across to Tomasino. Tomasino drops that back. Byron comes in, but Jiříček stepped into him. Byron quickly retreats. Mužík drops it back. And the pass goes back down to the Czech zone. Nyman's got it back. Tomasino goes to Kubicek. And the puck goes into the Czech bench. Tomorrow, a day off at the World Junior Championship. Semifinals are on Monday. The guy in the bottom right keeps changing his outfit. He had the flaps down early. Now he's gone full tuxedo. Here, ball.
Happy New Year.
I'm getting a sense he's from Newfoundland, judging by the flag there. As a bartender once told me, can't serve you a beer till noon. Want a drink while you wait? Kofor across the line. And the play is called offside.
A little bit of a scrambly start to this period as Canada tries to establish a little bit of consistency, some quick line changes, see if we can find a little bit of momentum shift to shift here, but probably a pretty good choice to get Cousins back on the ice. Two most noticeable forwards today have been Krebs and Cousins with their energy and the way they've got to the puck, but the rest of it is just a lot of this, a miss, and not quite on the same page. And the slower the pace of the game, I think, is more of a comfort to the Czechs, even though they trail by two here. You try and get a quick strike, maybe you can get a power play. They have a power play that's only drawn 7 power play chances in the preliminary round.
And Ray, we saw it in the earlier quarterfinal today. The Finns had nothing going in the first period and a bit against the Swedes. Get one and
well, the game complexion changes in a hurry. I think the one thing that stands out to me of changing without fans in the building is the teams that play Canada don't have to deal with that crazy momentum push against them. Right. It flattens out so quickly.
What a long shot. That's it, got the post and wide. McMichael chops it for 8.
Malik had no clue where that was. He was moving right. The puck went left.
Now McMichael centers it. Holloway digging for it. Cousins in. Try to center it. Cousins sends it back in. McMichael fanned on that. Here's Barron now. Justin Barron. Long wrist shot that deflects. Malik makes the stop. Once again, the puck bounced off him. And Malik has to quickly grab it. McMichael had his helmet knocked off.
We've talked enough about this line here. Cousins in particular with Holloway and McMichael. They're on for one of the goals. And here's one of the Canadians' best shifts. Shot that you can see. Malik has no idea. He's moving to his right. That misses on the left. The Barron shot was in the cage, had it hit. Michael will get a dried window and get his helmet back in a moment.
In comes Byram, shoots from a sharp angle, and Malik makes the stop, but there's no rebound.
Operation Puck Drop was created to bring hockey back to communities, families, and neighborhoods that have felt the impacts of the pandemic. To see more of the stories, visit OperationPuckDrop.ca.
Ah, the draw. Away comes Jiříček in his first major international tournament for the Czechs. We've talked in previous years about the Czech Republic having difficulty keeping their players at home. For a long time, they would come over in large numbers to play major junior in North America. As Zeri works in, corner Zeri with a burst, and the puck rolled off his stick. Now Krebs got buried in the corner, but made the pass back to the line. Byram winds his way, and Krebs retrieves his stick. As Byram crisscrosses to Drysdale. Jamie Drysdale. Across the top, has a look. Here's Krebs with it. Back down to Zeri. Zeri tied up. Banks it back to Drysdale. Across to Zeri. Crisp pass across to Byram. Now Drysdale with room. Walks right in and shoots. Malik makes the stop. The rebound dropped down the slot. And Vitus plays it down for the Czechs. And icing called. The exhausted Czechs have to stay on the ice. That's an unforced error there.
This is a critical shift here for Canada. Up 2-0. They've had two dominant shifts in a row. This is where you build momentum. You've got the Czechs reeling. They're tired. Everybody's trying to waste some time as they get back to the faceoff circle.
And I think Jiříček called timeout there. He's actually not eligible to do that. The coach has to do it. But so this is something you can't do in the NHL.
I can't stand this rule.
You think they shouldn't be allowed to call?
No chance. No chance. I loved when they changed this in the NHL. What's the point? It's supposed to be to generate offense, to have tired players on the ice. Look at him, please. Can I have timeout?
Well, ask your coach.
You're not eligible for the draft for 2 years. You can't call a timeout.
He's a late 2003 birthday.
What an interesting player he is to watch. Lots to like with David Jiříček. 6'3" already. Just 176 pounds. Lots of growth, of course, to come for him. So back to the original point. You've got the Czechs reeling a bit here. The Byfield line out. See if you can put another shift together to really keep them on their heels.
Schneider up for Quinn. In comes Jack Quinn, pivots back and plays it in deep. Byfield goes looking for it. Bumping there with Kubicek. Now Jiříček. Up ahead for Trigrio. He's got Mužík with him. And then Mužík and Gouli turn as Gouli gets their first to the loose puck. Plays it around to Byfield. Byfield, a rink wide pass, missed Pelche. And Kucherov races back for it. Kucherov being harassed there by Pelche. Throws that ahead to Baranek. And Baranek was stripped of the puck by Harlan. Quinn through the line, but not out. Mujic's shot was blocked. Gets it right back, and the second drive is blocked by Baron. Harley back with it now. Pelche sealed the wall. Tried to move it up for Canada. Played right back in. Orlovsky taken in hard by Baron. He was careful not to hit him from behind. And Baron up ahead for Harley. Canada changing as Harley moves in. And Kucherov knocks him down. A late change for Canada. That pass missed the intended target, Nyman. And the faceoff will go back down to the Czech zone.
The Czechs flatten the game out here for a minute. They won that faceoff against the Byfield line. Byfield doesn't win the draw, and so they can get it out of the zone, get some fresh skaters on the ice, and kind of get themselves back to level ground here.
Shots are even at 12 in the game. A 2-0 Canada lead. Back at the point is Byron. Going Byron across the Cousins, a shot that was blocked by Kucherov. Now McMichael, a centering pass, and a backhand foot wide by Holloway. Kofler couldn't move it out. Cousins on him, and now it's bumped up on a check forward. Grimes, that waits for teammates to get back on side, but not long enough. And the play is called at the check line. Devin Levi has started every game for Canada. And they have a 2-0 lead in the Czechs here in the quarters. We're happy to have past Chevrolet Good Deeds Cup champions represented here at the World Junior Championship. We want to hear your good deeds pitch. Visit ChevroletGoodDeedsCup.ca for more details. Drysdale across to Byram. Cousins on the forecheck on Scozio. Picked up by Holloway. That's knocked away by Meshack. Rink wide he goes. It's clipped in by Long. Drysdale. High off the glass. The puck loose at center ice for Cousins. He's got Holloway with him. Cousins works in for Holloway. That's knocked wide. And the Czech defender Tepley barreled into Malik. And Malik is slow to get to his feet. That was a hard collision between Tepley and his goaltender.
Man, it's hard enough if you have to watch for a 190-pound forward on your own team running over you.
Not to mention it seemed with 12 forwards, all of whom are first-round picks firing at you. Vitush. He was poked at the line. Scorzio moves in.
If you hadn't heard or just tuning in, Alex Newhook not playing for Canada today. A shoulder injury suffered in the game against Finland.
Tomasino drops it back for Suzuki. And now Schneider has to retreat as Raschka bears in on him. Schneider stays with him. Raschka still on it. Raschka centering pass. That just missed Vitush. Might the Czechs have another chance at this game, right? And it skips down to Levi.
There's been a couple of chances here. One of them has had an opportunity, sure, out of the odds, but the Czechs aren't out of this game yet.
Kubicek flips up the center ice. Mujik knocks it back down, or doesn't reach it, actually. Icing called against the Czech Republic.
Some really good defending by Canada leads to this 2-on-1. Holloway's going to the net, and there's Tepley, who's trying to come back to lift Dylan Holloway's stick. He ends up flying into Malik and into the back of the net. Now Malik's got to get up, find the puck, and continue to play goal. That can't feel very good.
His dad's claim to fame at one point was ending the, what was then the longest shootout in NHL history. Remember that? He was like the 14th shooter.
Oh, it was later than that. I think he went between his legs. A beauty. And actually, as great as that was, his celebration, he just put the left arm up in the air like he does it all the time. Great.
Harley in shoots, and Malik kicks that away. Perfetti taken down in the corner. Zeri to Krebs, wins that battle on the boards to Barron. Harley, a long shot, that's chipped wide by Perfetti. Zeri back with it. Connor Zeri is moving to the Newhook's center spot in this line. Now Krebs for Perfetti, drops it back for Zeri, the pass behind him. Philip Vickrin plays it back down to the Canadian zone. Harley backboard, Mujik watching him. Mujik wins the battle for the puck, and he missed Peranek with that pass. Now back at the point, the long shot taken by Kritzhill goes wide. Krebs lifts it down. Back goes Malik for it. Link wide pass to Kucheri. Quinn. Plays onside as he plays that towards the goal, picked up by Pelche. He drops it back. Byram hits the crossbar.
And the Czechs are having an absolute nightmare trying to keep a handle on Jamie Drysdale and Bowen Byram on the blue line. They're all over the offensive zone. Both of them just unbelievable skaters. And you see Byram time his entry into the play. Takes the pass and rings it off the crossbar up over Malik. He is going to be a stud in the NHL in no time. Man, that Colorado defense, just thinking of trying to get a handle on those guys, the way they skate, the way they move, and the depth of it. Imagine, what if they decide to play him and Makar together? He's going to chase those guys down.
Well, and it's not like Sam Girard's a slouch either. He's a terrific offensive puck mover.
And don't forget here, their first rounder in 2020 was Justin Barron.
Right.
You know, go back to Connor Timmins of a couple of years ago. They have got a nifty load of young defensemen on their team and right outside of their team.
Not to mention some forwards who aren't half bad either.
And those guys are okay too.
Byfield chips it down. The question is their goaltender, who we saw play here for the Czechs, Pavel Francouz. Or whoever winds up playing goal for them. Yeah. Here's Drysdale with it. Midway point of the second period. Jamie Drysdale. Out to center ice. Pelche. Flips that back in and Mishak back to pick it up. Long lead pass that missed Svozil. Icing again called against the Czechs. In that game against Russia, the Czechs played a very defensive style. They sat back for the first period and a half. Five guys skating backwards through center ice.
Not so much the case here. I mean, they've tried to be more aggressive, I think. There's been a lot of play in their zone, though, and you've seen a lot of these guys bent over here. So the one thing that happens, even if you don't score, if the pressure is shift after shift, relentless, you just wear the other team out. Eventually, they can't even mount an offensive charge.
Svozil for Mishak. Bounced by him. Barron back on it. Around for Gouley. Aiden Gouley, the Montreal first-rounder, chips that back to center ice. McMichael after it. Lead offside indicated against Canada. Now Cousins pokes it back into the Czech zone. Hosh plays that back across. Svozil up for Tepley. Tepley for Mishak. He was poked checked by Gouley. Long back on it. Tied up by Holloway. Holloway chops that ahead to Cousins. He's got McMichael with him. In comes Cousins. Drops for McMichael. McMichael walks right in. Shoots Malik. Save. And he pounces on the rebound and hangs on. 2-0 Canada leads here in the second period at the 2021 World Junior Championship in Edmonton.
Fifth World Junior Tournament for Andre Tourigny. First as head coach, we asked him who he's learned the most from, and he laughed and shamelessly said he considers himself a pickpocket. He steals from everybody. His attitude is every coach out there is better than him at something, and he makes it his mission to figure out what it is and learn that lesson from them. And guys, he told me that he and his staff did make a New Year's resolution, but said I was not allowed to ask what it was yet.
See, he's got that wrong, Ray. If you steal from one coach, if you take from one coach, that's stealing. If you take from several coaches, that's research.
Correct. And there's not one coach that doesn't do it. They're all looking for an edge somewhere. What's the next thing to learn?
Back in the glory days of the Oilers in Edmonton, there was a midget coach that used to sit in the stands and diagram their drills. Yep. Ken Hitchcock. Every practice.
Worked out well.
Trubicek drops that back. Out to center ice. It's picked off by Suzuki. Pass it to Mercer. And the play is offside.
For 4 years, teams have done amazing things to raise the Chevrolet Good Deeds Cup. But this year, ideas triumph. What would you do with $100,000 for your community?
Kind of a meandering pace to this second period. Not a whole lot happening. Not a lot of dangerous chances. A couple for Canada. Byram hit the crossbar. Justin Barron just missed on a point shot. And most of the play kind of coming in spits and spurts.
Coming up on 6:30 local time. Still to come tonight at 8:30 here, 10:30 Eastern. United States and Slovakia in the last quarterfinal of the day. Mujik stripped there by Harley. Thomas Harley pivots back. The puck got caught in his skates. Marked free by Pickrill. That shot drifted wide. Up the other side it comes. And waiting for it is Krebs. Peyton Krebs. In across the line, but the play is called offside at the Czech line.
Saw some good defense at both blue lines. Thomas Harley came up really tight on the Czech forward. No room to go. Turned over. Harley covers a lot of ground, the Dallas Stars first rounder. And then at the other end, it's Krebs is coming up the ice. There's such hard back pressure. There was nowhere to go, and the play's offside. And there's two examples of why there hasn't been any offense there.
the gaps the players have, the time they have with the puck is almost non-existent.
Skips down to Levi, hangs onto that as Brylovsky was looking for a bouncing puck.
He scored, or he set up the first goal against the Russians with just a remarkable effort. They've been on the ice for about 90 seconds, and Brylovsky blocked the shot, made this mad dash down the wing, and was able to find Colfer with the first goal of the game. He was gassed after it, couldn't even join the celebration.
Long shot from the point. Kucherov was blocked, and now Quinn plays it back down. Kucherov, high off the glass, back to center ice. Byfield swings back for it. Quinton Byfield back across to Byram. Bowen Byram up ahead to Quinn. He got stood up at the line. Nyman played that ahead, and Tepper was knocked off the puck. Quinn waiting for it. Bounces back at the point. Hosh, that shot goes wide of the goal. Drysdale digging for it. Byram comes in as well, picked up by Long. Martin Long, top line of the ice for the Czechs. That long shot goes wide. Kucherov back on it. Good pressure now by the Czechs. Kucherov taken down by Byfield. And the Czechs are hollering. That should have been a penalty. Hosh fires it right back down to the Canadian zone, and Levi out to play it. Brings it back around for Pelche. Chops at the center ice to McMichael, looking for Holloway. And Long goes back and plays it across to Sfosia. Lead pass to Mishak. Mishak was poke-checked there by Cousins. Mishak works in. Plays it rink wide. There's a quick chance for Long. Levi's got it. He just hangs on as he had a nervous look back.
Well, that was a little bit of a fight for Devin Levi as he'll get a drink of water. A little turnover at the offensive blue line. Cousins turns it over. And here's the shot from Long. And it almost squeaks underneath the pad of Levi right out on the toe. And he's able to just get enough of it to corral it. He's looking around, wondering where it is, but it was underneath his pad.
Novak knocked off the puck. And McMichael looks ahead for Cousins. Back is Kubacek. Cousins throws it back towards the front of the goal. It bounced away from Holloway. Brought back by Raška. Adam Raška, San Jose seventh round pick. Or should we say Scottsdale Sharks, since we're having their training camp. Oh, Barron collided with Raška. And McMichael feeds it down. Kubacek out to center ice. Suzuki stole that. And Novak with a long shoot-in, knocked away by Levi. Schneider for Tomasino. Malik back out to play it. That is that high off the glass. Tomasino knocked it down. Schneider shoots, it was blocked. And Kutil back to pick it up. Pass at center ice is knocked down by Harley. Back for Schneider. Tomasino feeds that back in. Krikrev lost the puck to Tomasino for a moment. Now Baranek has it back. Baranek a long shot, and Levi hangs on. 2-0 to score. 5:15 to go in the second. Time now for Gear Up with Skip the Dishes and the guys who bring you the games. There's Bill on the jib. He always says he's doing this up and down. Sean Dunham's been with us for more than 20 years. Michael Carroll. Terry McAlpine, known as Scalper. Terry Dunn. Terrific job. Scott Tetro, also a director from Ottawa. And Phil LaPlante Jr., known simply as Junior because, well, we like his dad better. Skip the Dishes, the official food delivery app of Hockey Canada.
As always, guys, unreal pictures. Unreal. You guys do an amazing job.
Don't miss a trick. Perfetti. Up ahead for Schneider. Krebs squeeze that by Sfosin. Krebs a backhand pass that was blocked in front by Hosh. Martin Hosh is a Washington fifth round pick. Eight of these Czech players are drafted. Now Schneider, lead pass to Perfetti. Cole Perfetti drops it back. Schneider in, he ripped that high and wide. And now Krebs, Perfetti, Gazzeri, that tip wide. Gazzeri back with it. Down to Krebs, feeds it back in. Perfetti just missed it. And Long back the other way. Myra by lethal pass. With the checks changing, in comes Perfetti. Cole Perfetti walks it and shoots. Malik makes a save. Long rebound to Drysdale. He skated by it. Byram backs him up. Byram back in the corner for Zeri. Zeri pivots back. Quinn pivots away from Meshack. Drops it back to Zeri. Zeri for Pelche. Jacob Pelche. Back down to Quinn. Quinn goes back. Byram fanned on it. Gathers it right back up and lays it back in deep for Pelche. Drysdale. Down to Byfield. Byfield for Byramwood pinched in. Long intercepts that. And the checks are off. Tepley was ahead of the play. Drysdale defending on three checks. And Juracek throws that towards the front of the goal. It's knocked down by Quinn.
Good positioning by Quinn to come back and help Byram, who's up the ice. He intercepts the play and they're out of trouble.
Pelche spins back. Definitely back with it at the line. He can't clear it out. Gooley, long shot, and Malik will glove that.
Byram looks like he's hardly even breathing. He's up and down the ice three times that last shift. This is pro defending. Pokes the puck out in a tight gap. The transition to Perfetti. One long pass, and Canada has a scoring chance off a really good defensive play by Byram. And a quick up to Cole Perfetti.
Now worked loose by McMichael at the side of the goal. You always wonder, Ray, with a player like Byram who's so dynamic, will he still be that aggressive in the NHL? Well, Cale Makar didn't miss a beat going to the top level. Vancouver Giants star.
Fourth overall by Colorado. His dad, Sean, was a New York Islanders draft pick.
He was drafted with a pick that Colorado got from Ottawa on the Matt Duchene deal. With a complicated, convoluted transaction, but that's ultimately how that end of it worked out. In comes McMichael. Throws it back in front. Cousins tip that wide. The puck gets by Gouley and back down the ice. And icing called against the Czechs. And you mentioned the Byram family. There they are in Cranbrook, B.C. Stacey, Sean doesn't. Sean and Grandma Jane. Hi, Grandma.
Sean doesn't look like he's too stressed out.
No, he seems quite calm about the whole thing. Tomasino, a long reach shot, and Malik got just a piece of that. Drysdale drops it back to Byram. Now Suzuki, a wraparound try. Malik poked that away. Tomasino tried to center it. He was tied up by Kutil. Just put high in the air by Raška. Drysdale knocked it down. Drysdale up for Mercer. Flipped in by Kurtil. And now Mushik with a sharp angle shot. That's stopped by Levi. Away comes Tomasino. Ahead to Mercer. Tomasino winds in. Rolled off his stick. Svozil plays it back out. Canada changing a race for it. Baranek. There's angle out there by Schneider. And it plays offside at the Canadian line with 1:29 to go here in the period.
Little fencing for Baranek and Tomasino, and a little, how do you do? Even though they haven't had but one chance this period, just the one shot from Long, The Czechs will be thrilled with this. They've kept the game tight. They're one shot away from
putting some pressure on Canada. And
maybe get a power play. And
but it's right there for them. Canada just cannot seem to find that next gear to put this one away. Not yet, anyway.
Zeri lays that in. Honor Zeri. Back to Schneider. At the line, Harley couldn't hold it. A chance down for Tipley. And Harley closed on him, and on the back check, Kraft took that away. As he reached back on Mishak.
Krebs put his head down as soon as that puck was turned over and makes an excellent back check to save that pass from being a mini breakaway.
McMichael back on it. Slides it back to Schneider. Schneider's shot went off the shin pad of Mishak. And the play called offside. A hand pass, actually, called against Canada. What hasn't he done?
Well, putting your head down is kind of a, I don't know, a catch-all phrase, but that was it. He put his head down. He knew that he had nothing else to do but then close the gap on that forward coming up the ice. And Krebs does it all the way. He gets a pat on the back as he saves a scoring chance.
Drysdale rings it around. Juracek, a steamroll there by Holloway. Holloway moves out of the corner. Bounces back in front, and Malik will pounce on that. Dylan Holloway is a big, thick player. 6'1", over 200 pounds already at the age of 19.
Had played a couple of games for the University of Wisconsin at Ohio State, scored both of them, and then came to the Canada camp, had to quarantine, and then they were in a mini quarantine, the college players as well, so he was off the ice for quite some time.
Drives up for Holloway. Malik plays it around. And Canada and the Czechs go to the dressing room for the second intermission with the score the same as when they went to the first. 2-0, Canada leads in the third of four quarterfinals today at the 2021 World Junior Hockey Championship. Our second intermission is coming up with James Duffy and Bob McKenzie.
This will be fun. Tons on the line tomorrow as the NFL regular season wraps up. The Dolphins can get in the playoffs if they beat the Bills. The Browns can get in if they beat the Steelers. The Cowboys Giants winner will get in if Washington loses. All of that happening on TSN and CTV. Don't miss any of Sunday's biggest plays with NFL Red Zone available for free on TSN.ca and the TSN app. Intermission number two, James Duffy, Bob McKenzie, and Craig Button. Since we had zero goals and very few brilliant chances, let's take a minute to appreciate the Canadian defense tandem of Bowen Byram and Jamie Drysdale. Bob, you've been to more than 30 of these. Is this one of the best pairings you've ever seen?
I really hate memory questions because all these tournaments seem to run into each other. But I can't imagine that there's ever been a defense pair for Team Canada at the World Juniors that skates like these guys skate because, quite frankly, they are elite skaters and they just hover over the ice. It's absolutely amazing, and they're so sound defensively, and when they do make mistakes, they have the ability to cover up for it. But this is just razzle-dazzle. And Byram and Drysdale, they've been doing this the whole tournament. And it is such a huge advantage for Team Canada to have two guys like that. I mean, two young defensemen I've seen where I first saw them skate for the first time, I went, wow. One was Paul Coffey, the other one was Jamie Drysdale as a 15-year-old. Different types of skaters, but crazy, Craig.
Well, you know, when you watch them, both of them, they're both in full control of the game. And if you're Andre Tournier, you have to feel this complete confidence when they're both out there together. You know you can play them in any situation. They do it with a high degree of competency. And as you point out, Bob, if there is a mistake, they're just so calm. They just move on to the next play and carry forth. But I haven't seen a better defense pair for Team Canada. We're not talking about post-junior into the NHL at this tournament that can match Drysdale and Byram.
These 40 minutes, though, were a lot different than the 40 minutes that Canada played against Finland, where it was complete and utter domination. First of all, we give credit to the Czechs. This is not the perfect game they played against the Russians, but it's certainly their second-best game of the tournament. But, Craig, where is the Team Canada that was flying against the Finns for those first 40 minutes?
Well, this isn't what they are. We saw their double-A game against the Finns. This is their B game. And Jeff O'Neill has always talked about, if you don't have your A game, you better have a B game. And Devin Levi becomes a part of that. That's a turnover in the neutral zone, a really significant save. And that's what you have to be able to do. So your B game requires good, solid goaltending, not leaky goaltending. Devin Levi gives them that. On another turnover, Braden Schneider trying to make a play. The puck slips away. And now what looks like a check opportunity, well, Peyton Krebs says, no, not on my watch, not when I'm on the ice. So, you know, everybody wants to have their A game. We saw it against Finland in that game. We're not seeing it here, but you got to be able to win with your B game. Jeff O'Neill with just more words of wisdom.
You know, the stereotype is that if the Czechs are trailing, they're not nearly as dangerous, that they're more of a front-running team. You give them a lead and they're going to protect it and they'll lock you down. But if you get ahead of them by a couple of goals, that's it, it's game over. I don't get the feeling at all that the Czechs feel like they're out of this game. I think right now Malik has settled down in that second period. The two goals that were scored weren't entirely his fault, but he looked a little leaky. And there was that feeling early on that Canada was going to run them right through the end of the rink. What they may need to do to try to get inside the Czech defense is more of what Phil Tomasino did late in that period, and that is body to the net for one of the forwards in Dawson Mercer, puck to the net from Tomasino. That is how the Americans ultimately broke down the Czechs. They did it earlier in the hockey game, but right now the Czechs are still very much a credible threat because they believe, the way they're playing, they believe they can come back and capitalize on some of those turnovers.
You're bang on. They fell down 2-0 to the Americans, lost 7-0. They had fallen down 2-0 to the Swedes, lost 7-1, but here, very much in this one, and kind of reminiscent of the Russia-Germany game this morning, where it was 2-0 Russians. The Germans got a goal in the third and almost tied it late. We'll see what the Czechs can do against Canada with 20 minutes left. Another crazy Alberta 50-50, already up to $2.8 million. It was $7.6 million the other night, which still has not been claimed because I don't want to tell Bob we won because I'm worried he'll leave.
I think our ticket.
Yeah, you have until 10:30 Mountain Time tonight, if that was your winning ticket, to claim that 50-50. We'll see where it gets you tonight with still another game to go. Two quarterfinals earlier today. Let's start with Russia and Germany. First period, Russia shorthanded, but they gained control. And really, their PK was the story all day. Vasily Ponomarev in all alone and scores. Dennis Bayak, 2-0 in the third. Florin Eliash overskates it, steals it back, and we have a hockey game. It's one goal lead for the heavily favored Russians. Later on, John Paterka deflected and off iron, and Russia holds on barely for the 2-1 victory.
With a 2-1 win, advances.
I think we had a chance today. A stupid power play goal from us in the first period. That can't happen if we want to win against those guys.
Congrats to Germany for making the quarters after all their positive COVID tests. Tim Stützle is amazing. Finland, Sweden. Swedes up 1-0 on the power play. Elmer Söderblom, terrific between his legs. Second time he's done that. He's 6'6". Lucas Raymond, Söderblom, both Detroit. Bunch of Detroit prospects in this game all over the place, by the way. Anton Lundell right there on the power play. We have a tie game. The Finns come all the way back from 2-0. And now last minute of the game, 23 seconds left. Ronnie Hirvonen buries the wraparound as the Finns come back to stun the Swedes. They're off to the semifinals, and Sweden goes home. They've won one gold medal in the last 40 years at this tournament. U.S.-Slovakia, your final quarterfinal tonight, 10:30 p.m. Eastern, 8:30 Mountain, 7:30 Pacific here on TSN. We continue to track the quality shots in this game from our friends at SportLogic. Canada has taken the lead, a 14-9 advantage, and the two red dots representing the two Canadian goals. But still very much a hockey game with one period to go. Johnny Orlando plays to the third.
Tell me what you're going to do now.
Back here in Edmonton, no scoring in the second period. The shots were 10-6 in favor of Canada, even at 18 overall through 40 minutes of play. Gord Miller back here with Ray Ferraro. You thought before the tournament that Canada's strength would be this puck-moving defense.
What an enormous asset to have a couple of guys that can get around the offensive zone as easily as Jamie Drysdale and Bowen Byram do. Byram has played about 21 minutes a game in the tournament. He's already at 17. Look at Justin Barron walk across the blue line. His shot beats the goaltender but doesn't hit the net. Now Byram and Drysdale, they're like impossible to get a handle on. All over the zone, they've now switched sides once, they'll switch sides twice. Barron will move it once, and now Harley shovels it towards the net. This is really difficult for the Czechs to handle, so what they've decided to do is just stay deep. They're not getting out to challenge Canada's defense. That gives them lots of time. However, the real challenge is getting from the blue line into the slot area where it's just plugged up. 18-18 are the shots. Canada leads by two. Those early first period goals have been all we've seen offensively tonight.
In comes McMichael, shoots, and Malik makes the quick stop.
There's a guy stressing a little bit to score right now, and that's Connor McMichael. He hit three posts the other night against Finland. Last year, 5 goals in 7 games in the tournament, so he gets a little bit of a 2-on-1 on the first shift here of this period, and he ends up hitting Nick Malik right in the crest.
Hasn't played this year.
Yeah, they just start to press just a little bit. Everybody tells you, oh, just relax, and it's not that easy.
Tried a long shot, that goes wide. Don't you love it when people tell you to relax?
I'm trying! It doesn't work.
Get that down to the Canadian zone, icing called.
And all you need is just one little bounce, one little hop, because he's getting plenty of chances. But you get tired of people telling you you're getting chances, it's going to even out. You're just waiting for it to come to you in the right spot where it ends up in the net.
Byram back to Peltier with a shot that was blocked by Vitus. Byram pokes that ahead, trying to find Zeri. Vitus back out, it gets by Barron and back down. Byram heads off on a change.
Here, Canada, you want to defend this lead about 100 feet away from where Justin Barron is standing. Get it in the offensive end of the ice and just forecheck and pressure. Don't let them even come near your end.
Juracek, Sue McMichael, that just squirts across the line.
That's a good play by McMichael.
Lead pass to Krebs, puts it rink wide to Cousins. Cousins drops it down to Gouley, who jumped in. Now Krebs has a quick look.
Krebs out here with McMichael and Cousins. Usually a spot for Dylan Holloway.
Barron swings back for that loose puck. Banks it off the sideboard. It's knocked down at center ice by Nyman. Nyman works in. Throws it back in front. Templey spins and shoots. That's blocked, still loose. Back in the point it goes to Kucheny. His shot's blocked. A chance now is Cousins looking at for McMichael. He was in behind the Czech defense, but the pass missed. Kutin. Rink wide for Raška. Orlovsky, rather. And the puck bounces back in front. Schneider for Tomasino. High in the air, back down the check line. Kutil batted that ahead. Harley knocks it down and works his way in. Rounds it off to Suzuki. Works it and shoots. It goes off the leg of Kutil. Still loose in front. And Suzuki couldn't reach it. Orlovsky plays it back. Harley up ahead to Quinn. Rink wide to Schneider. Is after his own shoot-in. Mishak pivots back. Up ahead for Svozil. In comes Mishak. He was poke-checked here by Byron. What a defensive play that was. Now Perfetti. Back for Suzuki. Nuji. Back out to center. Pass by Long. Then back in by Svozil. That pass misfired for Nuji. Osh trying to milk and icing out of that, couldn't get it. Took the longest route back he could. Kubacek. Long shoot in. And Levi's got it. So it's getting late in the evening, early in the morning in the Czech Republic. So we say ahoy to all the fans of the Czech Republic.
Looking for a goal to see if their team can get back into this.
Well, it's amazing the Czechs haven't won a medal in 15 years. It's not like they don't turn out good players. David Pasternak is one of the best goal scorers in the NHL. He played his junior hockey in Sweden, and a number of Czechs have followed him on that path. As Novak swings it across. Drysdale back with it. There's only been one power play so far in the game. That went to Canada in the first period. Perfetti. Gains center ice. Lifts that out for Mercer. Dawson Mercer on it now. He gets loose. Mercer. Locked off stride. Jam play at the center of the goal. Malik Pope checked it. And Tepley's got it back for the Czechs. His pass went off the skate. It's onside for Zary. Now Zary busts in and shoots short side. Malik kind of spun to make that save. And Harley plays it ahead to Holloway. So Andre Tournier juggling the lines here in the third period. As Schneider goes back, this is Holloway with Pelche and Zary.
Yeah, it looks like he's flipped Holloway and Krebs here to start this third period.
Kurtil. Banks it back in. Schneider had to be quick with that. Braden Schneider. Prince Albert native plays it back. Plays his junior hockey in Brandon, which, if you missed it earlier, he's going to name a street after Ray Ferraro.
Yeah, that was pretty cool to read the other day. That was awesome.
Long shoot in, and Levi hangs onto that. So what's our friend from Newfoundland doing? Oh, no. In the bottom right.
Outstanding. There, we got the goal light in the middle.
Yeah, this is good
set to go.
Awesome. Nova Scotia represented. By the way, I hope Ray Ferraro Drive is a bumpy road.
Nope. Be well looked after. I think no stoplights, but one of those roundabouts.
It'll be easy to get lost on it, though.
Obviously.
Here comes Krebs with it.
Yeah, that's a certain.
Now Gouley works it with McMichael. Caden Gouley shoots. That goes wide up the other side for McMichael. Back to Krebs. Orlovsky. Gets his way through the middle for Svozil. He's knocked down by Gouley, and Svozil remains on the ice as he slides back in the corner. The Czechs howling about that. Krebs. Up ahead for Tomasino. Icing waved off as Lund goes back for it. Long cross ice pass. Drysdale got there. Up, run in by Mishak. And Mishak. Ray had a great year when he went to Hamilton last year. 15 goals in 22 games after the World Junior Championship. Juracek, a long shot. That goes wide. Quinn on it. He's got Tomasino streaking ahead. Goes rink wide instead for Suzuki. And Suzuki drops it off in the corner to Quinn. Quinn banks it back around. Suzuki takes a whack there from Juracek. It's bumped by Tomasino as Byram goes back. And icing is called.
There's Stanislav Svozil, draft eligible this year, has come to the blue line where Gouley gets him across the arms as he puts his stick up and catches him in the no-pad zone on the inside of your elbows. Montreal Canadiens first rounder has had a really steady tournament for Canada.
The first overall pick in the Western Hockey League draft by Prince Albert in 2017. He went to the Raiders after his brother Brennan played there. He used to go watch him play when he was younger. And he joked in Prince Albert, someday you're going to play here too. Sure enough, it happened. There's Mercer, a long shot. Save made. Rebound for Perfetti. Bobble the puck in front. Nugent Jones on that shoot in. For Zach, a lead pass for Perfetti that missed. Icing call against Canada. What a chance for Perfetti there.
Perfetti had 66 points in 32 games after he was released from training camp last year for Hockey Canada. Just went on a tear. Really hasn't been able to get on track. He kind of double clutches and the puck ends up through his feet. He's got one goal in this tournament so far.
A terrific Hlinka Gretzky cut for Canada in the Czech Republic last year. In the semifinal against the Swedes, he scored both goals in regulation and all three goals in the shootout, including the winner. Turned 19 yesterday. Paul Perfetti, a dynamic offensive player for Saginaw, the Ontario League, was a first round pick, 10th overall to Winnipeg in the last NHL draft. He was the OHL and CHL Scholastic Player of the Year last year.
The Jets project him as a centerman at this point. He's playing the wing here.
Krebs chips that back to center ice. Hosh back across the slows. The other shoots it in, and Harley arranges back to pick it up. Definitely trying to work it free. Harley battles there with Baranek. By the way, Michael pulls it out. He's got Krebs with him and Cousins. There's Krebs. Brings that around, and the puck goes off the glass, up and out of play. 12:08 to go here in Edmonton. Team Canada 2-0 lead on the checks. Time now for the Gatorade shift of the game.
Make an impact at both ends of the ice, and Dylan Cousins has done it all tournament. We've seen it for two tournaments. A block shot. Connor McMichael finds him up ahead of the pack. 8 minutes into the first period, Dylan Cousins is on the board.
Gatorade, rehydrate, replenish, refuel. Holloway wins that faceoff back to Peltier. Gouley to Jacob Peltier. Back for Caden Gouley. Shoots, and Malik makes a stop and hangs on. And we mentioned earlier, Dylan Cousins moving up Canada's all-time point list at this tournament, now alone in sixth spot, two behind Jason Allison, who played in the 94 and 95 World Juniors. He was a beast for Canada in a gold medal win in 1995 in the tournament held in Red Deer, but it was more the Alberta World Junior. Canada played games in Calgary, here in Edmonton as well. Of course, Red Deer was to be one of the host cities for this World Junior, and will be next year. Zary flips that back in front, and Malik's got it.
Like a little bit of the traffic around the front of the net. That's more of the way that you can generate an offensive chance to make the Czechs back on their heels. This is the previous faceoff. Holloway wins the draw. Watch how stationary they are. They want to get to the front of the net. Zary finally moves out of there, but when Holloway moves out of there, the puck comes to the net. One guy in front, one guy flare out. Look at the difference here. Zary in the front of the net. Holloway's out a little deeper. Now there's a puck to the net. You can attack it.
Zary flips it back in.
Really difficult always with the Czechs just trying to plug up the middle of the ice, and they've done it really well.
Peltier picked off that pass. He winds his way in. Peltier flings that across. Picked up there by Holloway. In for Barron, who jumps in. Justin Barron shoots from a sharp angle, and Malik makes the stop on that.
A little sort of scrum here. The only been one power play in the game. Yep. Canada had it. The Czechs have only generated 7 power play goals in the 4 games and 2 periods that they've played. It's such an important part of a team, of an offense, and they just haven't had any opportunity at it.
Well, especially the underdog.
Sure, you're going to need something out of a special team here. And pretty clearly, with 11 minutes left, the Czechs have to find something good to happen to them in a hurry.
Byron gets their first icing called against the Czechs, and the nightcap tonight is the United States against the Slovaks in the fourth quarter final game of the day. 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific time here on TSN. Four games today on this ice surface. According to the officials and the players, it's held up very well. But this is a brand new state-of-the-art building, an ice plant. There's no fans in the building, so the temperature doesn't go up. They control it better. I can't imagine what the ice would look like in a lot of NHL buildings.
Sure.
With three games or four games a day on it. It would be, as our good friend Alex Kovalev used to describe bad ice, like a potato field.
I'm assuming that's bumpy. We used to call it a ran on a rock pile with a tennis ball.
Quinn flips that back in the corner. Tomasino after it. And that lead pass, this Peranek. Suzuki flips that back down. Horzak jumps back up, seals it along the wall. Canada missing, it changes. Horzak kicking at it. And that puck takes a beating.
The Czechs are not that far away from having to get their defense into the play here. Take a chance. They're going to have to find a way to generate an offensive scoring chance because it's just not coming for them.
Baranek flipped it high in the air. Tepley knocked it back to center ice, and Cousins got it back. And a big hit there, Cousins and Baranek. Now Cousins puts it back behind the goal for McMichael, just out of his reach. Hot, got his pocket picked by McMichael. Krebs to Cousins, to McMichael. Back in front, Cousins a shot! And that goes off a stick, over the glass, and out of play. Past the midway point of the third period, Canada a 2-0 lead. Coming later tonight, SportsCenter. There's Laura Dykin in the middle of the SportsCenter cast. Amazingly, the cutout of Rod Smith in the upper right, that's actually actual size.
That was Miller Gordon, Rod.
Yes, that's true. Shouldn't mess with the former offensive lineman from Queens. There's Gulli, a shot at the outside of the goal frame. Gulli back with it. Mercer. For Byfield. Now Byfield trying to pick that frame. And finally, the outlet pass goes to Rylofsky, rather. Mercer got bumped off the puck. Kubicek fires that dump on the wrong side of center ice, and the Czechs can't get anything going here.
No, they're climbing uphill. They're grinding away here. They're trying to get possession of the puck, and you can see what the attempt is. Get it in the zone, see if you can forecheck a little bit. But Canada's quickness here, while we're not seeing it with the puck, without it, it's denying the Czechs any space. There's just nowhere for them to go with it. And look at the tight gap there that Byram and Drysdale are able to keep because of their skating ability. It's tough to make a play.
Back at the point, that's chip one of the goal. There's Mujik, got a stick on that. Czechs were mentioned, no medals in the last 15 years. Their best finished fourth. 3 years ago in Buffalo, they've won one quarterfinal matchup in the last 15 years. Krebs drops it back. Kutil swings back. The Czechs have undertaken a program to try to improve youth hockey and junior hockey in their country. Much like the Germans have, and the German program is paying dividends. Here's Krebs with it. Krebs drops it back. McMichael in, shoots, he rattled that high.
What a play by Krebs.
Harlech to McMichael. He shoots, that was blocked. As Nyman got in the way of that. Perry Tech was off the glass and out. The faceoff will stay in the Czech zone.
What a great play by Krebs here on the wall as he's going to use his quickness to shake the checker by changing directions. He'll go down the wall, and when he feels that
The checker's on his back, gone. And then he's going to find McMichael in a great scoring shot. McMichael knows where he wants to go, right up over the shoulder and under the bar. He just airmails it.
Harley reaches up, keeps that alive. Back in deep for Zeri. Connor Zeri digging for it. Played his minor hockey in Saskatoon for the Saskatoon Contacts organization, which must hold the record for the most players sent for the Canadian World Junior Team. The Shen brothers, and just a long list of players in that minor hockey organization. Harley fan of the clearing attempt. Mishak, but tied up by Holloway. Novak plays it back. That shot was blocked as Zeri got in the way of the drive from Sozio. Holloway works in, Canada changing as Holloway got crunched along the sideboards. Rashka, long pass up to Sozio. He needs a change. And as they change, Holloway busts in with Tomasino. Tomasino. Tied up there by Kubicek. Inside 7 to go here in the third period. Worked in now by Baranek. He's tied up in the corner by Barron. And a chance now for Tomasino. He's got Quinn with him. The third man, Barron jumps in. Tomasino in, shoots, and it's off the arm of Malik, up and out of play.
Tomasino decides to carry that the entire length of the ice. He didn't want to try and squeeze a pass in, and it's probably the safe play at this time of the game. He had Barron jumping up from a long way back. That shot deflects off of Kubicek's stick as he's shooting with Quinn going to the net.
Kubicek was named a top three player for the Czechs last year. As a 17-year-old, he's one of the 10 Czechs who can return next year. Icing waved off as Barron goes back. Shot free by Nyman, throws it back in front. That pitch pass just missed Barlovsky. And McMichael lost it, and a long shot there by Krutil is gloved by Levi.
We haven't seen much of Devon Levi here, but there's another example of what has made him so impressive. There's a bit of a scramble. There hasn't been much action, and when he gets his hand on the puck, the play is dead. Little scramble in front of the net. Wroclawski tries to push it to the net, and when this puck comes to Krutil, Levi finds the puck, and it's then going to be able to get himself focused and square to it. Finished. Play over.
Mužić's shot is blocked as Byram has it back and drops it back to Drysdale. Cool. Krutil with a hard hit there as he nailed Suzuki. 20 years ago, the Czechs were the kings of men's hockey. They were the reigning Olympic champions, the reigning world champions, were two-time reigning world junior champions. One goal of this tournament, 2000 and 2001. That shot off the stick, up and out of play. It's a 2-0 lead for Canada in the quarterfinals of the 2021 World Junior Hockey Championship.
We've previously talked about the focus and preparation of Devon Levi, stretching between whistles, trying to keep himself loose. Just watch his head. Just focus on his head as he tracks the puck. Watch how quickly he's moving. Boom, he looks to his right, he looks to his left, and now he's found it again. Goalies talk about the necessity of puck tracking, and there was a great example of how Devon Levi gets it done.
Harley chops it down for Cousins. Sends that down. Krebs won't get there in time, so the check net is empty. The extra skater is on with 5.5 to go here in the third period. So a gamble by Karel Jelinek, the head coach of the Czech Republic.
So I guess you look at this and your thought is you need two and you're not generating anything. So let's try and get a sixth player on the ice here. You better hope that your centerman can control the draw.
He does. And tipping up the shot away. That was blocked. Here's Hosh with it. Across the lung. Back to Hosh for Mishak. Mishak walks in and shoots. Chance to the side of the goal to jam away at it. And Rashka couldn't catch. Now it's picked off. McMichael bats it ahead, a race for it against Meshack. McMichael trying to throw that back in front for Krebs. And back come the checks the other way. Wow. Plays it across to Raschka. His pass goes off a stick and back up to center ice. Osh to Raschka. Harley stepped into him. Meshack comes after it. Byron stepped into him. The centering pass. Knocked down by Cousins. Harley puts it off the sideboards. Back to center. And Meshack touches up, but the play's offside at the Canadian line. And now the faceoff will come outside. And we'll see if they put Malik back in. They will.
Now some nervous moments around the Canadian net as Meshack's shot deflects wide. Now Levi's got to react quickly as Raschka picks that puck up off the end boards. You see Levi quick look, find the puck, and then get back to the post before Raschka can get to the open side. So now you keep Malik back in the net here. You've got your top guys, offensive guys on the bench. You keep Malik back until you can at least get those guys back on the ice.
Juracek.
He's good.
Swings that pass ahead for Nyman. Nyman, a sharp angle shot. And Levi makes a stop, and now Malik's got back to the bench. The extra skater comes on. It's Teplin. Pelche swings it back to Holloway. To Byram.
That's really good work by Pelche to slow everything down.
That lead pass or shot missed. Icing the faceoff back down to the Canadian zone. 4:09 to go, and the big boys come back out for the checks.
And Drysdale misses that pass up the middle. He's looking for a deflection. It doesn't happen, and so the icing comes back, and Canada will have Suzuki taking the draw against Meshack.
Meshack wins it. Teplin a shot. Levi the save. Byron on his backhand can't clear it out. Battle for it along the wall. Back it goes to Meshack. To the point. Hosh, a long shot kicked up by Levi. Inside four to go here in the third period. Hosh in for Meshack. Meshack. Back across to Hosh. Lots of traffic in front. Raschka to the front of the goal. Knocked away by Drysdale. The puck's still loose in the corner. At the line. Hosh. Long shot. Levi the save. And Teplin couldn't reach the rebound. Hosh. Another long shot. Levi save. Again, he can't corral the rebound. And a little drive. This time countered wide by Raschka. It goes back down to the check zone. Long up ahead for Meshack. Late pass for Krickler. Krickler. And behind the goal. Teplin trying to reach it. Check net is empty. Barron reaching for it. And Krebs digs it free. Dooley up to center ice. It bounces to McMichael. He's got Krebs with him. And McMichael beats his man long. And deposits that in the empty net.
Maybe that's all it takes. It's Connor McMichael into the empty net. Seals the deal for Canada. Canada had not given up 20 shots in a game in this tournament. They've given up 27 tonight to the Czechs, who with the goalie out, really put a press on Canada. Gouley chips this off the glass, and McMichael's the beneficiary. As Canada stretches it out to 3-0.
Connor McMichael, with 5 goals in 7 games last year, now has his third of this World Junior. That's a 3-0 lead for Canada. The Czechs ice the puck.
That's got to be so discouraging for the Czechs, as now that it's 3 and the empty net has failed them, it's so deflating as they all have to watch McMichael go and put this into the empty net. Devin Levi, some of his best work towards the end of this third period, as the Czechs had 3 or 4 really good scoring chances.
Harley, long shot, Malik the save.
by number 18, Pinkcrest.
Through Teal. Throws out ahead. And Puffer taking a shot. Wayne Mercer's got it back. Still to come tonight, United States and Slovakia, the fourth quarterfinal of the day. Russia and Finland have already advanced. Byfield. Gotta lay that back in. Kucherik. Penalty coming now to Canada as Gouley touches up. And the hooking call is going to go against Canada's Quinton Byfield, and so the Czechs have got a power play here with 1:58 to go in the third.
Well, you'll get the goalie out now.
Canada number 19, minor penalty hooking.
There's the hook through the hands by Byfield, and for the Czechs, a ineffective power play in the tournament that hasn't been on the ice here. I am a little surprised they got Malik back in the net. I'd have six guys out here now.
Czechs also don't have a timeout. They used that earlier after an icing. Hosh. Back from Mišák. On this Czech power play, which is 1-for-7 in the tournament, as I mentioned. Mišák back to Hosh. Mišák has that power play goal, but it's turned over now. And the puck back at center ice. Jan Mišák drops it back. Roshka unloads that. And Levi plays that ahead for Quinn. Drysdale. Battles there for it. Loses the sign of the goal. Byram puts that free. And Owen Byram has it back. High. Back for Tepley. In for Mišák. That back. Tepley a shot that deflects wide. Here's Mišák. Centering pass by Long, moved on goal. Good shot there for Roshka. That's kicked away by Levi. Inside a minute to go now in the third period. Off the bench comes Svozil. Drops that back for Kukrier. And Quinn knocks that back for Barron. Two early goals for Canada in this game. Dylan Cousins scored 8.5 minutes in, and less than 12 minutes in, Bowen Byram made it 2-0. And Canada's cruise from there until the empty net goal by McMichael. Canada has yet to trail in a game in this tournament. But the road ahead gets much tougher.
There's no easy way in now. And if the U.S. are able to win tonight, that sets up a Canada-Russia semifinal. The U.S. and the Finns would be the other. Got to hand it to the Czechs here. They played their two best games of the tournament against the Russians and Canada. They just don't have enough offense to hang with Canada. Canada's on to the semifinals.
A 3-0 win. Devin Levi makes 29 saves for his second shutout of this World Junior Championship, and it's on to the semifinal on Monday for Canada, the opponent to be determined. Canada won today without Alex Newhook. We'll see if he can return for the semis. And for the Czechs, it'll be another year out of the medals of the World Junior. 16 consecutive. We're going to get their top three players of the game presentation, then the player of the game presentations, and the Canadian anthem. Proud hockey country, the Czech Republic. Next year will be the 30th anniversary of the Velvet Divorce when the Czechs and Slovaks split right in the middle of the World Junior Championship.
The best players of each team is presented by Explore Edmonton, the visitor economy and venue management organization for Edmonton. Each winner will be awarded with a custom wallet from local maker, Close General Leather Company. Recipients will receive their award after they exit the ice. The best player of Team Czech Republic, et le numéro 5, number 5, Stanislav Zvoksil. The best player of Team Canada, et le numéro 4, number 4, Bowen Byram. And now for the three best players of the 2021 IIHF World Junior Championship for Team Czech Republic. The three best players are selected by their team and will each receive a TISO watch. The three best players of Team Czech Republic are number 4, Radek Kucherík. Number 8, David Juracek. And number 19, Jan Mišák. Et maintenant, pour l'hymne national, for the national anthem of Team Canada.
World Junior Hockey Championship from Edmonton, Alberta is brought to you in part by Esso. The Esso brand has fueled Canada's love of hockey for over 80 years. By Nike, official gear of Canada's national hockey teams. By TELUS, helping build stronger communities on and off the ice. When we give back together, we're all connected for good. And by Tim Hortons, the official coffee of Team Canada. The 2021 World Junior Hockey Championship from Edmonton, Alberta is brought to you in part by Chevrolet. Find new reasons to cheer. Find new roads.
So we're three quarters of the way there, and here's the scenario. If the Americans win, Canada versus Russia in one semifinal, USA versus Finland in the other. If Slovakia somehow pulls off the upset, Canada would play Slovakia, and Russia versus Finland would be the other semifinal. We know this part. Monday, both semifinals. Canada will play, no matter what, in the early semifinal, 5:30 p.m. Eastern, for the pregame show.
Little break for SportsCenter, and then we are back for the final game tonight. The U.S. against Slovakia, 10:30 p.m. Eastern time. Drop of the puck just a few minutes after that. Certainly was not the prettiest victory ever for Canada, but give credit to the Czech Republic, who are frustrating to play against at times, and this was one of those times. But the Canadians get it done. Terrific goaltending by Devan Levi, Dylan Cousins, 2 points, and Canada will play for a medal at the World Juniors.